What's up, my YouTube family? Sergeant Greybeard with the Gaming Brigade back with another Division 2 video. Today is Friday, August 20th, and as always, I hope this message finds you healthy and safe. In today's video, my friends, I'll be showing you how to get the Ridgeway's Pride exotic chess piece in the game. And many of you have reached out to the channel asking if the actual method has changed over the last 6 or 8 months. Everything is pretty much the same, but I wanted to cover it with you once again today. Now, if you happen to be new to the channel, first of all, welcome. Secondly, feel free to hit that subscribe or join button. We would love for you to be a part of our gaming family. And if you enjoyed this or found it helpful at all, if you could hit that like button, it would really help us out. Finally, as most of you know, we have giveaways here, and our current one is for an Xbox Series S, and all you need to do to enter is either subscribe here or follow us on Twitter. Either way is fine. The winner will be announced on October 2nd of this year, and just to clarify, you do not need to join as a member in order to enter the contest. We do have monthly prizes for membership. However, for the Xbox giveaway, all you need to do, as I said, is subscribe or follow on Twitter. Having said that, let's get into today's video. One thing I'd like to mention really quick as we begin is that some of this footage is new within the last month, and some of the footage is from that first video that I put out. However, the most important aspect is that all of the steps are exactly the same on how to get this thing, so if you have any questions whatsoever, please let me know in the comment section down below. So the first thing I want to cover in the video has to do with summit keys. You see I'm rolling up on one right now. You need to pick these up. Now the summit keys you will find every 3 floors, and those keys will open the caches that you find right before the elevator. Now keep in mind, you saw that I found this first key on floor 3. However, it could have been on 1, 2, or 3. So really take your time as you're going through the floors, look for the key, because again, once you take that elevator up, you cannot go back down in order to try to find a key that you may have missed. Keep in mind that opening these caches will not only get you the exotic components that you need in order to craft Ridgeway's Pride, but you'll also be able to pick up some really good loot. So again, my friends, take your time and make sure you pick these things up. Now, in regards to the caches themselves, as I said a moment ago, you're going to find them in a locked room right before you take the elevator up to the next floor. They can also be in an actual cache that is right by the elevator door, but again, you will find it before you take that elevator up. Now, there are 5 components in total that you need to craft in order to get Ridgeway's Pride. The first one is the body armor, and you're going to find that between floors 1 through 20. So in that case, you saw I got it on floor 3. However, you can get it between any of those first 20 floors, so again, if you don't get it the first time, do not worry. The next component you're looking for, my friends, are the shoulder pads, and those are located between floors 20 through 40. Now, once again, you can find a cache every 3 floors, so you do have 6 attempts in order to find it between those 20 floors, so again, really take your time and find those keys. The next component you're looking for is the hunting knife, and you'll be able to find that somewhere between floors 40 through 60. And one thing I want to make sure I mention as we move on is you can do this on any difficulty whatsoever. You can see here I'm doing this on normal, that way it could just rip through the thing and get all the stuff I needed. Moving on to the final 2 components that you're going to need, you will need to find the flag patch between floors 60 and 80, and then the dog tags between 80 and 100. And one thing I've heard from a lot of players, and this is what I did, is I made sure I did every floor in the summit without skipping any. Now, the main reason I'm saying that is I've heard from some gamers saying that they skipped some floors in the summit, meaning they were able to get all the components, but let's say, you know, they use matchmaking, they skipped to floor, you know, 18 and then to floor 37 and whatnot. Now, they got all the components, but at the end of finishing the actual summit, the project they needed wasn't there. Now, I will be going over all of the details in regards to the Ridgeway's Pride Summit project in a moment. However, if you've gotten all the components, gotten to the top of the summit, finished it, and the project did not show up in your actual list, please let me know in the comment section down below. So getting back to the footage you're looking at now, once you've gotten to the top of the summit, you're going to go to floor, obviously, 100. You go into the observatory. That's where you will face 2 hunters, depending on if you're playing solo or not. Obviously, if you're in a group, there are going to be more hunters, but the main thing is you take them out, and that is what gets you to the next step in the project. Now, as most of you probably know by now, with this game, when you're playing in the summit, if you die in between one of those 3 floors, let's say you're starting on floor 90, you die on floor 92, it takes you back down to 90. However, with the summit, if you happen to die, the hunters take you out, you will still be right at floor 100, so you will not need to go back far. Once you've killed the hunters, you will see, obviously, some loot drop, and one of them should drop the Zero F's piece of body armor. Now, it is very important you save this, because you will need it to craft Ridgeway's Pride, and again, this is just one step of the rest of the grind you need to put together in order to get the thing. Now, upon completing the summit itself, then you will see in your projects tab, you'll see an actual Ridgeway's Pride project. Now, as you can see on the screen, you'll have to donate some things, a weapon with the Sadist talent, that piece of body armor with Perfectly Unbreakable, as well as an exotic component. Now, for those of you wondering how do you get an exotic component, all you need to do is break down a current exotic that you have. Now, if you don't have an extra one in your inventory or anything like that, then you're going to need to do some farming, but once you get an exotic, again, break it down, and that will give you the component. Another step you'll need to take is donating a bunch of faction keys and also taking out a bunch of named enemies from the different factions. I personally recommend doing control points on Heroic. You're going to find named enemies there, and if that doesn't work, definitely hit up some bounties. You can also hit the sewers in different areas on the map. There happen to be these lockboxes that have keys inside them. Now, those keys are on a 24-hour timer, so once you grab one from a certain lockbox, you will not be able to open that box again for 24 hours. It is a bit of a grind, but again, if you run out of bounties, it's a great way to get them. Now, you can see at the bottom of this list, the final two types of NPCs you need to take out are two rogue agents and two hunters. Now, starting with the rogue agents, I'm going to leave a link to a video that I put together showing you some of the most consistent places on the map that I was able to find them. Now, when it comes to the hunters, you do have a few different options there. So some of you, or most of you may know, that they're scattered around DC and New York. I have not put a video together on them. However, you can find one online and it will show you where they're located and how to actually get them to spawn. However, what I chose to do was this. I went back to the summit because we know there are two hunters at floor 100. And all I did is I used matchmaking to hopefully join a group that was further along in the summit and I could kind of skip ahead to get to the top. Now, having said that, if you're going to skip ahead those floors, you know, and use matchmaking, two things you want to make sure. First of all, do not just join a group and bail, because then it messes up the group, the difficulty scaling gets all jacked up, and that's on you, and it's just really not a cool thing to do. Secondly, you want to make sure you complete at least three floors with the group. That way you'll be guaranteed to be locked into whatever floor that you finished on when you actually left the group. So again, I would say stay at least 3 to 6 floors. So no matter what, you're good to go. Once you reach the top, my friends, you take out the hunters. Once that's done, you can then go to the actual crafting bench. You can see here, you can craft Ridgeway's Pride. This thing is an absolute monster. And again, it is without a doubt, definitely worth the grind. As I mentioned at the beginning of this thing, if you happen to be new here, feel free to hit that subscribe or join button. If you enjoyed this, you could hit that like button. But most importantly, take care of yourselves, be kind to each other, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks again, everyone.